topic is magnetism. From this, we are going to study magnetic moment. Magnetic moment of an electron. Okay, so we have to study what? Magnetic moment of an electron which is revolving around the nucleus. Okay, so now if I draw the diagram for this topic, then you can see that this is the circular path of an electron. Okay, in this circular path, the electron is going to move, that is, it is called as what? Orbit. Here in the middle, there is a nucleus, right? So if you see that this is the nucleus, and here the electron is going to move. Okay, so in this way the electron is going to move. Let us say that this is the direction of electron. Now if you have studied in current electricity, whenever there is a flow of electron, there is always, yes, there is always a generation of current. So therefore here, whenever the electron is going to, if the electron is going to move in an anti-clockwise, then the current is being formed in opposite direction. Okay, so let us say that this is the flow of current I. Now if you have seen that from here, the center to the radius, so center to the electron, this is the distance, nothing but called as what? Radius of the orbit in which this electron is going to move. Okay, so in this topic we have to just remove magnetic moment of an electron. So for that, we have already seen that there is a flow of electron, and therefore there is what? Production of current. So therefore first step is nothing but current I. So current I is nothing but what? Rate of flow of charge. Okay, so E upon T I have written. So E is nothing but charge. Before this you have studied about this formula, that is Q upon T. Q is nothing but charge. So here in this diagram we have seen that the electron is moving in a circular direction. So this is the charge which is moving, and due to this charge, what is happening? Current is being produced. So therefore here we will write E upon T. Now if this electron is taking a revolution around the nucleus, so what is the time taken for one revolution? So we have to remove time. So let us see what is the period of revolution. So period of revolution is nothing but what? Period of revolution. So period of revolution is E is equal to circumference divided by velocity. Okay, so from where this came? This came from the basic formula, that is V. Velocity is equal to distance upon time. Distance upon time. So what is the distance traveled by the electron? It is nothing but what? It is the distance traveled by the electron is nothing but the, yes, circular path. This is the circular path in which the electron is going to move. So this circular path is nothing but what? Circumference, right? So if you have to find out the time, let the time come on this side. So T is equal to distance upon velocity. So distance is nothing but circumference upon velocity. Okay. So according to this, what is the circumference of a circle? Circumference of a circle is nothing but 2 pi r divided by V. Okay, so this is the period of revolution. Now let us put this formula in this equation. So therefore the current I is equal to, yes, the current I will become E divided by 2 pi r divided by V. Okay, so it will become, this V comes on numerator. So therefore E V divided by 2 pi r. So this is the current which is being produced due to the revolution of the electrons. Okay. So now we have got time. Now let us see. The next point is nothing but, next step is nothing but what? Magnetic moment. Okay. So if the magnetic moment of an orbital electron, magnetic moment of an orbital electron, so the magnetic moment of an orbital electron is nothing but m. Now just remember this, orbital electron, due to this orbital electron, n number of revolution it will take, right? And due to which current has been produced around some area. So this is nothing but what? Magnetic moment of an orbital electron. Now let us say that only for one revolution we will take. So n is nothing but 1. Okay, so this formula will become what? Ia. Now we have the formula for I, right? So let us say that m is equal to, what is the I equation we got? We got Ev divided by 2 pi r. Now what is the area? It is nothing but the circular area, right? So circular area is nothing but pi r square. Now can you see this pi gets cancelled, I gets cancelled. So m is equal to Ev r divided by 2. Okay, so this is the magnetic moment of the orbital electron. Now here only we have to not stop. Now here another term will come over here, that is angular momentum. From this this angular momentum was given, this idea was given by whom? We have taken the reference from Bohr's postulate here. Okay, so according to second postulate, second postulate of Bohr's theory, so according to this postulate we can say that this angular momentum which is denoted by L, capital L, so this angular momentum is equal to mvr. This m is nothing but mass of electron. Okay, so mass of electron, capital V and R. Okay, so this term we have to introduce in this equation. Now how can we introduce this term in this equation? You can see that there is a velocity, there is an R over here, only what is not there, it is m, right? So how can we introduce? We have to just divide and multiply the equation, that is this equation, momentum's equation. Okay, divide and multiply equation number 1 by 2. Okay, by applying this what we get, m is equal to ME, mass of electron. Okay, and over here it is 2 divided by ME. So according if you divide and multiply this ME, there is no changes in this equation. Okay, so we have not at all changed the sequence significance of this equation. Okay, so now just multiplying and dividing by ME we will get this equation, right? So therefore, since what we can write, since L is equal to mvr, so therefore this mvr will become L. So therefore we will get m is equal to E divided by 2ME, and this term will come, this is nothing but what? L. Okay, so therefore we will get E upon 2ML. So if I take this L on this side, so it will be what? M divided by L is equal to E divided by 2ME. Okay, so you can see here this E is nothing but charge of electron. This 2 is also constant. This ME is nothing but mass of electrons. So therefore, these term is called as, these are nothing but what? Constants. So therefore, this M upon L is nothing but, it is a constant. And this constant is nothing but called as what? Gyromagnetic ratio. Okay. This M upon L is nothing but gyromagnetic ratio. Okay. Now, this is another term, that is, this is called as equation number 2. Now, if I write this term in scalar quantity, vector quantity, so it will be m bar is equal to minus e upon 2 m e l bar. Okay, so now how this minus sign came? This minus sign will tell you that this magnetic moment and the angular momentum, they are in opposite direction. So therefore, due to this, the minus sign came over here. Okay, so this is the vector form. So this is nothing but what? Vector form. Okay. Now, according to this, this L we have already done from, we have taken it from the reference. Yes, Bohr's second postulate, right? So according to this Bohr's second postulate, L is also equal to mH upon 2 pi. Okay, n is nothing but principal quantum number. So principal, according to this principal quantum number, you can say that this, if you introduce this in this equation, what you will get? You will get m is equal to e divided by 2 m e l bar. It is nothing but n h upon 2 pi. If I write it in E in a different way, it will be E M H divided by 2 twos of 4 pi M E M bar. Okay. So, this is also another equation. This is also in vector form and this is also in, yes, scalar form. This is nothing but, as I have told you, this is called as what? Gyromagnetic equation. You can solve this. And the answer will come what? 8.8 into 10 to the power 10. Okay. Try to solve this. E is nothing but charge of electron 2. And ME is nothing but mass of electron. Okay. Try to solve this. You will get the constant value. Okay. So this M upon L, this term, the ratio of magnetic moment divided by to the angular momentum is called as what? Gyromagnetic ratio. Gyromagnetic ratio. Okay. So, this is all about the magnetic moment of an electron which is moving in a circular, yes, orbit, okay, around the nucleus. Okay.